we've done Greenwich Circus Festival for 10 years. This is the 10th. That's why this year's a special year. We kind of learn off the back of every year how to make it better.
I'm Nick Litton. I'm a founder member of an organisation called The Hangar, which was a live workspace, very crusty and organic, which we started in 2002. That has morphed over the years into what you see today. Aircraft live in a hangar, and that's so we still have a connection to that past, even though the first school was The Hangar. This is now our third school.
I met Nick in 2002, so I didn't really have anything to do with the first school, which was 2002-2007. I came on board with the second school in 2007, Hangar Arts Trust, which was here, before we converted in 2018 to this Aircraft Circus Academy.
We got a lot of expertise in the early years, of not just performing, but the technical stuff behind it, that underpinned it, and that's really what circus is short of. There are so many more schools than there were 10 years ago, but they're still in the minority. There are less than 30 full-time circus schools in the whole of the UK. We average about 200 visitors a week, pre-COVID, obviously. COVID has obviously affected those figures, but 95% of them are probably doing a lesson in circus.
So we have our toddler tots, age 2 to 4, then trapeze tots are 4 to 6. Circus ninjas are 6 to 10. And then the big ninjas are 10 to 12, then there's teens 13 to 17. But then we have the adult program, we also have a foundation, like a full-time training program for those crazy kids who want to become professional circus artists. All ages, all abilities. No, basically people come, they come to us and we're like, you want to learn circus? Come on, let's do it.
Yeah.
And it really is as simple as that. Because people think, certainly adults, they're like, oh, it's for kids. We can't do it. And we just prove people wrong.
My name is Clyde Jimbicus, and I've been doing circus for not that long, I think about 2 years. So I did the four-month course. I trained in every discipline. Circus is a lot more free than competition gymnastics. So you've got rules and with circus, you can like just perform and do what you want. When I first started it, it was a bit scary because I've always been on the ground. So being up and like far up was a bit nerve-wracking, but now I'm used to it. I like it. Yeah, I do get that like adrenaline rush. But yeah, I definitely recommend it to anyone. Just, it hurts your body. Yeah, it's just the burns that you get, but you get used to it. But when you're performing it and doing it, you can't feel it. It's just after you're like, oh, but yeah. It's worth it.
Now I get on it. Between them, they were 58, 62, 3, 63, 121. Which means that I'm just a bit heavier than the both of them together, but not enough to take account of friction through the system. So if I get on, I'm going to have to climb and force my way down a little.
Together. So it's really important that we do all the behind the scenes things so that everything just runs seamlessly when we do it, so no one's thinking, oh well, what's next, or how do we do the next bit. I have a few different roles here at Aircraft, so I mainly do marketing for them. And then I also perform with the company and do reception and a bit of tech as well. I started circus 4 years ago, and Started at Aircraft 3 years ago on their full-time course. It's brilliant. It's so nice because everyone gets it. Everyone knows that this week's going to be really intense and it's just about doing it and it'll all be okay in the end.
I'm cabin crew at my day job, but I come here and I perform and perform with the school as well. I get some job opportunities. So normally it's a mix between working and then coming to train as well. They're very flexible here. You know, I come in at my days off and they're so supportive. The thing about Aircraft, it just feels like a massive family here. You know, it's so supportive an environment. And I mean, this is my place to hang out as well. It's nice to see all the familiar faces and that. So it's just one big family it feels here at Aircraft.
I started circus when I was about 8 years old. And then when I was 15, as I came and did my first show, Madame Payne's, with Aircraft Circus. And then from there, I started attending Aircraft Circus and I did their full-time course when I was 15. Since I left Aircraft, I went over to Montreal to the National Circus School there, did a year or two there, and then I left, came back to London, was kind of working the London scene, going to all the auditions I could do, and then 2 years ago, Cirque du Soleil picked me up with Crystal. So I went and joined their tour. So we did a North American tour, Mexico, Russia, and then we came to the UK, and then COVID hit, and then I'm back to Aircraft again. It's really nice to see like all the familiar faces and seeing that everyone's doing good. The company's still up and running and everyone's happy and safe. So it's really nice just to reconnect with the circus community here. Yeah, and that's the amazing thing about circus is no matter where you go, is you find those people, and you, when you come back, you've always got people that you know. It's always been a pleasure working with Nick and Lucy. They're really knowledgeable, so they've managed to blur the line of being hard and strict, but being personable and really nice to work with at the same time, because you can see that they have the knowledge. And they pass that on to a way that is really encouraging and it doesn't put you down at all. So always coming back is nice to be welcomed back into the space and also have an expert eye to help with whatever we're trying to do. I'd say take the leap, find some online, some classes online and book on, come to the space, try out different disciplines, because you might come in and try one discipline and like, oh no, circus isn't really for me. But no, there are many, many options there. So come in, try a variety and find the one that you love, and I'm sure there'll be something for everyone. And once you've got that bug, it sticks with you.
We start planning in August for the shows, especially this year. Everything's just pulled together in literally the last week because with COVID, people were in, people were out, we had no idea. We've had to cancel two of the kids' shows, saying, oh, my child's isolating. So we're like, okay, up to the last minute. We're like, which kids do we have? You're out, you're in. So it's challenging.
Yeah.
We're going from a school into a venue.
Yeah.
And then we don't have a tech team of people that do that. We run the school. We put on the show. We get the venue together. We do the sound. We do the lights.
Yeah.
Very small tech team.
Every year
after the festival, we always say, never again.
Yeah.
We're never doing this again. But yeah, obviously we love it. So that's why we do it, because it is exciting. It's adrenaline.
Yeah.
It's satisfying.